Rappers, are you stuck? Do you need advice? Do you not know the next step to take in your music career? Don't worry, I got something special for you.
Hey, hey, get that, bet that, jump shot, wet that, post moves, no rules, chef that, no boo.
Hey, what's up? I'm Leezy the Gifted. I've been rapping and putting out music for 9 years, and I've been producing my own music fully for 2 years. So through all my years of experience, I've put together a few tips that I guarantee are gonna help you in your music career. And if you want more videos like this, subscribe to the channel and hit the bell notification so that you don't miss anything, because every single week in 2020, I'm gonna be putting out a new video. So let's get into these tips. Okay, so tip number one, produce your own music. I know that's crazy. I know you've probably not heard that advice, but here's why you need to produce your own music. For the first 7 years of my career, I did not produce my own music. I went through so many challenges with that. I didn't have the money to get all the beats I needed. I didn't really have the money to pay for pro studio time. I didn't know what I was doing with mixing and mastering, so my songs weren't really coming out as professional as I wanted, and of course, I didn't have the money to get them professionally produced and mixed and mastered and engineered, which I'm sure you're in that same position. So I figured, all right, maybe I need to start producing my own music. And the past 2 years have been insane for me. In 2018, I think I put out 10 songs, which in the grand scheme of things, doesn't sound like a lot, but for me, it was 10 songs in 1 year. In 2019, I put out 18 songs or maybe 19 songs. And then this year, 2020, I'm already on pace to put out 2 songs a month, 24 years. How much does it cost me to put out those songs? Zero, nothing. So I highly suggest you learn how to produce your own music. At the very least, learn how to make beats. Learn how to make beats, learn some basic mixing and mastering stuff. If you want some tips on learning how to make your own beats without spending a lot of money and without needing to be an expert on the piano, you should go check out the playlist that's on my YouTube channel. It's called How to Make Beats. Go check it out. It's super easy and it's super fun actually on making your own beats. And at the end, you're gonna have unlimited exclusive rights to your own songs. It's not gonna cost you anything. Think about where your career can go from there. And as well as not just being able to produce my own music, but I've been able to open up another income stream, which is selling beats online. I've even had great mentorship from a couple of amazing people like Gabe the Legion and Anno Domini, and that wouldn't have happened if I didn't learn how to produce my own music. I thought of myself as just a rapper. When I started producing my own music, it opened up a whole new world for me. Point number two, think of yourself as a business. 2 weeks ago, I put out a video about branding for rappers, and it's very similar to this point that I'm making right now. But think of yourself as a business and as a brand. You're not just a person. You're not just putting out music. You need to become a brand. And remember, the oxygen of every single business, money. Get that money, baby. Look, if you need to figure out a way to hustle and do things that are a little bit outside of your realm of music, that's totally fine if you're gonna put it into music. Clothing, social media management, which I do, by the way, website development, doing shows and getting paid. If you produce your own music, you can get paid to produce other people's music. Just remember, you're a business. You know it, and I know you're in this position where money is tough right now, so do whatever it takes to get that money and put it into your music career, because I guarantee you this, yes, you can do organic reach. Yes, you can market yourself without spending money, but it's super difficult. It takes a really long time and a lot of patience. I think that's what you need to do. All those things, do them. The networking on IG, the Gary V strategy, this, that, and the third. But eventually you're gonna need to get some money. You want clothes, you need to get money, right? You wanna do shows, there's money involved. You're probably gonna need to sell tickets. The venue is probably gonna want you to sell a minimum amount of tickets. I can do a whole nother video about performing and getting shows. If you want that, you should comment below. I wanna know how to do shows. Leezy, whatever. But think of yourself as a business. You need to get money, you need to get your accounting right, you need to figure out ways to be able to pump a little bit of cash into your music career. It's super important. Do it. Point number three, go to local open mic nights. Now, I wanna crush all the excuses right now. If you are sitting there thinking, I don't have any open mic nights local, dude, freaking use Google, type local open mic nights. If you're really in that small of a town, then get your ass in the car and go drive to a town that does have an open mic night. Here's why. Open mic nights are a completely free way to perform. You get to do one, sometimes you get to do 2 songs. I've been doing open mic night where I did 2 songs. It's a great way for you to practice performing with a microphone in front of a crowd. It's a great way for you to get those nervous jitters and butterflies out of your system before you go and do a show where you had to sell tickets. I've done so many, I don't even know how many open mic nights I've done at this point. It's a lot. Between 10 and 15 open mic nights. It's a lot. They're great. And you end up meeting somebody who runs the open mic night. They might be able to book you for an even bigger show. So think about that. That could be a great opportunity. My first ever client that paid me to mix and master his music, he paid me $650. I met him at an open mic night. He saw me perform. I saw him perform. He liked me. I liked him. We did business. He gave me cash to mix and master his music, all off of an open mic night. Now, here's what I will say. I hate going to open mic nights right now. And I'm saying that and being honest with you because I want you to be prepared. Open mic nights sometimes can be ran very unprofessional and super disorganized, and it can take a lot of your time. So I want you to be prepared. It's a mixed bag. Sometimes you'll go and it's a first come, first serve. Sometimes it's like, we're gonna put all the names in a hat, we're gonna randomly draw, and then we're just gonna write down the names in order of how we've pulled them out of the hat. It happens, okay? Here's what I have for you. Set yourself a time limit. Be like, all right, I'm not gonna stay at this open mic night past 11 p.m. or 12 a.m. or 10, whatever it is. And do that and just sit there, watch people perform, go up to them and say, yo, I really, really, really like what you did. Get their Instagram, get their phone number. Go talk to every other artist. Yo, I like what you did. Get their phone number, get their Instagram. Go talk to the people who are working at the bar. Go talk to the waitresses. Say, hey, yo, thank you so much for all your service. Hey, you guys are doing a great job. Go link up with the sound guy. He might know people who could help you perform. Yo, I really like what you did. Appreciate you. Go talk to the MC. Yo, appreciate you. Love you. So no matter what happens, open mic nights are an amazing opportunity for you to make contacts and collaborate with people, even if you don't perform. So go to local open mic nights. Okay, so point number four and point number five actually go hand in hand with each other. So point number four, don't listen to the haters. Now, that's super cliche. I know that that's out there. I know that a lot of people say it, but I bet that you're probably a little bit insecure about your music. If you're not, great, that's cool. But if you are, just listen. Everybody sucks when they start. When I started freaking 9 years ago, when I was 17, I sucked. I was terrible. Everybody sucks when they start. Don't trip. You're gonna be able to move past it. Your entire career is not predicated on the beginning. So don't trip about people who hate on you. Look, I've had people in high school who talk mad crap about me to my face, behind my back. I didn't let it get to me. And I've had so many people comment on Facebook and on Instagram. You're trash, you suck, another Lil Dicky, you are like Machine Gun Kelly, but a trash version, Lil Peep would be turning in his grave. I've had so many people talk hella crap about me. Dude, it's water off my back, bro, I don't care, it's all good. Plus the other thing is, if somebody really is gonna take the time to say something mean and negative to you, I actually feel really bad for them, because that means their life probably sucks. But point number five, you need to take feedback and critiques. So be careful. When I say don't listen to the haters, yes, but there are people who are gonna give you really, really, really good feedback and critiques, and you need that, okay? So when I first started in music, I'm gonna shout out two of my homies, Evan Maeda and Abe Zilkich. Those dudes would tear me apart when I would show them my songs. Especially Abe would spend 6 seconds listening to the songs, and then Abe would go, this sucks, I'm good, I'm done. It would piss me off, but he's like, dude, I'm giving you honest feedback. People don't listen to music for more than 5-6 seconds. So if you're not grabbing me in the first 6 seconds, bro, I'm done with it. And Evan was just like giving me great advice, great feedback, and he would just tear me up, say, look, bro, if you wanna be considered with Kendrick Lamar and J. Cole and Drake, like, yeah, your music sucks. And honestly, you should realistically be thinking that. You're competing with those dudes, because that's what attention is. We're all competing for attention, and you are competing with those big names. So if your music isn't matching up to the quality of those artists, you're screwed, honestly, and you need to think of yourself that way. So yes, don't listen to the haters, but please take feedback and critiques. I'll mention this. A couple of my other homies weren't giving me that feedback. They were being very, like, yes men. They were being really positive. They thought that positivity was what was gonna push me. And it helped, but I said, look guys, you are not going to be able to help me if you're not shooting me down. I need you to think of critiques. I need you to fake it a little bit. Even if you think the song is good, come up with things that suck about the song and just tell me about them and just make my music seem like it's not good enough so that I can get better. Guess what? A few years later, my friend Evan, the guy who was tearing me down, he got to a point where he was like, dude, I have nothing else to say about your music. It's good. It's at the point where it needs to be. It's super high quality. Guess what? That's how I knew it was really good, because he had been talking so much crap about my music to my face before that. So I knew when he told me it was good, it was real. So look, those are five tips for you rappers out there that needs some advice and that needs some next steps. Hey, if you got any value out of this video, this is what you need to do. Click below and subscribe to the channel and hit the bell notification, because every single week I'm gonna be putting out a video in 2020 and I wanna help you get further in your music career. Hey, thank you so much and have an amazing rest of your day. Peace.